Hello everyone and welcome back to your channel Lawpedia. This is me Jasmine and in continuation of our bail series that we were doing. आज के हम अपने इस वीडियो में समझेंगे एवरीथिंग अबाउट एंटिसिपेटरी बेल. सो आई हैव इंक्लूडेड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो सर्टेन लैंडमार्क केसेस ऑफ द एंटिसिपेटरी बेल, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एंटिसिपेटरी बेल एंड सर्टेन रीसेंट डिसीजंस दैट विल अपडेट योर नॉलेज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एंटिसिपेटरी बेल. क्विकली गेटिंग स्टार्टेड, फर्स्टली वेरी रिसेंटली On 21st of October 2021, Supreme Court delivered a judgment. जहां पे Supreme Court in a case where the Patna High Court had granted anticipatory bail to an absconder, had set aside the said order, stating that if anyone is declared as an absconder or a proclaimed offender in terms of Section 82 of your Criminal Procedure Code, he or she is not entitled to the relief of anticipatory bail. So moving forward and understanding the concept of anticipatory bail. Before moving forward, a short story for everyone that how did this anticipatory bail concept come about. So now this particular anticipatory bail concept was completely alien to the old criminal procedure code. That means pehle ye concept nahi tha. However, for the very first time, Law Commission in its report dated September 24th, 1969, यानी कि 1969 में लॉ कमीशन ने इस पर्टिकुलर कॉन्सेप्ट को हाईलाइट किया था. दैट मीन्स इट ड्र्यू द अटेंशन ऑफ द नेसेसिटी ऑफ इंट्रोड्यूसिंग अ प्रोविजन इन द कोड फॉर ग्रांटिंग एंटिसिपेटरी बेल बाय द हाई कोर्ट एंड द सेशन कोर्ट. सो वहां से ये डेवलप हुआ ये कॉन्सेप्ट दैट फॉर प्रोटेक्टिंग अ पर्सन हु इज अप्रेहेंडिंग अरेस्ट. कोई भी ऐसा पर्सन जिसको लगता है कि वो अरेस्ट हो सकता है, दैट मीन्स हिज और हर पर्सनल लिबर्टी में भी चैलेंज, ऐसा कोई पर्सन अप्लाई कर सके कोर्ट को फॉर एंटिसिपेटरी बेल. दिस वॉज द आइडिया डेवलप बाय द लॉ कमीशन. Further, the initial idea of providing for an anticipatory bail was to avoid the situation where a person needed to obtain a bail after being arrested, even while reasonable grounds exist for the same prior to arrest. Therefore, in 1973, sections 436, 437 and 439 of the Criminal Procedure Code dealing with the grant of bail was streamlined, and a new provision, that is your section 438, for anticipatory bail was introduced. So this is a small little background story before understanding what is anticipatory bail all about. Moving quickly forward and knowing what your section 438 is all about. So now half the battle is won if we understand the section itself. Now the section has certain important crucial points that I have stated over here. So agar aap section 438 padhenge, it starts with where any person has reason to believe. So the very first key point would be reason to believe hona chahiye, that he may be arrested. The second point, that he may be arrested. On what? On accusations of having committed a non-bailable offense. He may apply to High Court or the Sessions Court. And in this particular section, court may, after taking into considerations certain factors, grant such a person anticipatory bail. What are the factors that court may see if we should grant or not grant anticipatory bail are the nature and gravity of accusation. The second factor the court may see is whether the person has previously undergone imprisonment on conviction by a court in respect of any cognizable offense. So koi previous conviction hai of the same person ki. Third factor court may observe is possibility of the applicant to flee from justice. So this is one of the factors. The fourth factor court may also see is whether the accusation has been made with the object of injuring or humiliating the applicant by having him arrested. Moving forward, now anticipatory bail ke cases mein a 7 days notice will be given together with the copy of the interim order that has been given under clause 1. And ye superintendent of police ko bhi diya jayega. Why? Reason kyun dena hai? To give the public prosecutor a reasonable opportunity of being heard when the application is finally heard and decided by the court. Moving forward, we all are aware about that whenever court grants a bail, and this is applicable even in anticipatory bail, court kuch conditions laga sakte hain, court kuch restrictions laga sakte hain, so that you know the justice system is not tampered with while we are upholding the personal liberty of a person. So certain conditions that may be imposed by the court are that the person should make himself or herself available for interrogation. तो कोर्ट ये कह सकता है कि जब भी विल कॉल यू फॉर इंटेरोगेशन यू हैव टू मेक योर सेल्फ अवेलेबल. नाउ कोर्ट ये भी कह सकता है दैट आप कोई इंड्यूसमेंट नहीं करेंगे, कोई थ्रेट नहीं करेंगे, नो प्रॉमिस टू एनी पर्सन जो कि एक्वेंटेड है विद द फैक्ट्स एंड सर्कमस्टांसेस ऑफ द केस. सो ऐसे कोई भी पर्सन दैट मे इंक्लूड द पर्सन हु वॉज अक्यूज विद यू, आप उससे कोई कॉन्टैक्ट नहीं मेंटेन करेंगे. यू विल नॉट हैव एनी कॉन्टैक्ट और एनी इंड्यूसमेंट और थ्रेट विद द पर्सन हु आर एक्वेंटेड विद द फैक्ट्स ऑफ द केस. कोर्ट में ऑल्सो से दैट प्लीज आप इंडिया नहीं छोड़ेंगे, यू विल नॉट लीव इंडिया विदाउट द परमिशन ऑफ द कोर्ट. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड वील बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग वेयर टू सीक रिलीफ. नाउ आप कहाँ जाएंगे फॉर सीकिंग एंटिसिपेटरी बेल, ये क्वेश्चन एक बहुत ही फंडामेंटल क्वेश्चन है. वेयर विल यू गो? इट इज वेल सेटल नाउ दैट बोथ हाई कोर्ट एंड सेशंस कोर्ट हैव कॉन्करेंट ज्यूरिसडिक्शन. जब आप 438 पढ़ेंगे यू विल रियलाइज ओके वी कैन मूव टू हाई कोर्ट एंड वी कैन मूव टू सेशन कोर्ट, सो वेयर डू वी गो? नाउ यहाँ पे एक फैक्टर आता है दैट इट इज हाउएवर जनरली एक्सेप्टेड प्रैक्टिस टू अप्रोच फर्स्ट द सेशंस कोर्ट एंड देयर आफ्टर अप्रोच द हाई कोर्ट. नाउ ये एक जनरल प्रैक्टिस है जो कि फॉलो होती है दैट पहले आप सेशंस कोर्ट जाएंगे एंड फिर यू विल मूव टू द हाई कोर्ट. बिकॉज वेयर अ पर्सन चूजेस टू मूव टू द सेशन कोर्ट इन द फर्स्ट इंस्टेंस अ रिविजन विल लाई इन द हाई कोर्ट. वेरी सिंपल, प्लेन एंड क्लियर. सेशंस कोर्ट में गए आपको एंटिसिपेटरी बेल नहीं मिली, यू कैन मूव टू द हाई कोर्ट अगेंस्ट दैट पर्टिकुलर डिसीजन कोर्ट. सो दिस इज द जनरल प्रैक्टिस दैट इज बीइंग फॉलोड. So now, moving forward and understanding one of the most landmark judgments of anticipatory bail section 438, that is Gurbaksh Singh Sibya and others versus State of Punjab. So now, ye ek bahut hi landmark judgment hai which is covered every time you understand section 438. So now, the basic background story in this particular case is Gurbaksh Singh Sibya, that is the appellant, was a minister of irrigation and power in the government of Punjab. He and few of other ministers were facing accusations of corruption and apprehended arrest. And so now this particular minister was apprehending arrest, so he moved to the High Court for grant of anticipatory bail under section 438. So now this is the basic story. However, the anticipatory bail was denied. So the person moved to the Supreme Court to seek the same relief. So now Supreme Court ne is case mein ek holistic guidelines laid down kari for the court to consider while granting anticipatory bail. So now I have covered certain important guidelines over here so that you are able to understand the concept of anticipatory bail better. So now ye matter jab Supreme Court mein aaya, Supreme Court elaborately discussed about the concept of anticipatory bail, when it should be granted, why it is granted, what consideration should court take before granting or not granting the anticipatory bail. Hence, this became the landmark judgment for the concept of anticipatory bail. Now, court ne is particular case mein state kiya, the power though of extraordinary character does not justify its use in exceptional cases. Ye aap har case mein nahi apply kar sakte. That means there are certain exceptional cases where you will be okay a little bit more cautious before granting anticipatory bail. Due care, caution and circumspection must be used while exercising such power. Second factor, the individual applying for anticipatory bail must have reasonable apprehension of getting arrested for a non-bailable offence, which can be objectively examined by the court. So now, a reasonable apprehension, that means ye koi aapke dimag ki apni story nahi ho sakta. Let's say if a person is just going and stating some story before court that so and so thing has happened and I may be arrested, that means court yahan bhi keh sakta hai that how can we objectively examine that yes, you will be arrested for a non-bailable offense. Hence, we may not grant anticipatory bail. The third important factor court stated was anticipatory bail must not be denied in cases where the accused is suspected to have committed an offense punishable in the form of death penalty or life imprisonment unless the court has sufficient evidence before it to justify the refusal. So now court ne ye bhi kaha, if the person has been accused or has been suspected of commission of such an offense which goes to death penalty or life imprisonment, just on those grounds aap anticipatory bail deny nahi kar sakte. Court also stated that blanket and protective orders of bail should not be passed. Also, for efficient investigation, certain conditions can be imposed under Section 438(2), such as on discovery of material or evidence in regard to the case. Court ne ye bhi kaha, filing of an FIR is not a conditional precedent to the grant of anticipatory bail under Section 438. That means if I am going to court for anticipatory bail, aisa mandatory nahi hai that an FIR should be filed and then only I move to the court that okay, please grant me anticipatory bail. Even though the first information report has not been filed and I have reasonable sufficient grounds to believe that I may be arrested for a non-bailable offense, I can move to the court for the grant of anticipatory bail. Court also stated that the provisions under Section 438 cannot be evoked after the arrest has been made. Agar arrest ho gaya hai, there is no anticipation aspect, so you can't move for anticipatory bail. Court also stated under Section 438, interim bail order can be passed without issuing a notice to the public prosecutor, but it should be mandatorily issued to him afterwards. We have all understood this aspect. The court has the discretionary power to impose suitable conditions in case of such interim bail. So after understanding a landmark judgment, we'll be finishing the video with another very recent case of 2021, that is Nathu Singh versus State of Uttar Pradesh and others. So in this particular case, court stated a very interesting factor. That's why I have included it in the video. Even when the court is not inclined to grant anticipatory bail to accused, there may be circumstances where High Court is of the opinion that it is necessary to protect the person apprehending arrest for some time due to exceptional circumstances. Now, ये एक बहुत ही fundamental factor court ने यहाँ पे develop किया and state किया that even when हमें overall circumstances देख के लग रहा है that the person A should not be granted anticipatory bail. Even in those cases, court is giving a relief. That means, agar court ko koi exceptional circumstances lagte hain, so the person apprehending arrest, us person ko protection provide ki ja sakti hai for certain specific period of time. Now, what are the exceptional circumstances? Supreme Court expressly gives an example in this particular case. One of these exceptional circumstances would be if the person is the primary caregiver or the breadwinner of his or her family members and needs to make arrangements for them. While a High Court or Session Court is giving such an order must be a reasoned one. And with this, we come to the end of our video. I really, really hope you did understand certain important aspects related to anticipatory bail. And if you did, please like, share and subscribe. Also do let us know in the comment section below if you have any doubts with respect to anticipatory bail, you can write to us. Of course, we'll get back to you. And as we always say, until the next video, stay home, stay safe and keep learning.